Good Christians all, both great and small, I pray you lend an ear and listen with attention while the truth I will declare. When you hear this lamentation, it will cause you to weep and to wail about the suffocation in the mines of Avondale. On the 6th day of September, 1869, those miners all then got a call to go work in the mines. But little did they think that day that death would soon prevail before they would return again from the mines in Avondale. The women and the children, their hearts were filled with joy to see their men go to their work, and likewise every boy. But a dismal sight in broad daylight soon made them all turn pale when they saw the breaker burning o'er the mines in Avondale. From here and there and everywhere they gathered in a crowd, some tearing out their clothes and hair and shouting right out loud, "Get out our husbands and our sons, for death is going to steal their lives away without delay in the mines of Avondale." But, oh, alas, there was no way one single soul to save, for there is no second outlet in that subterranean cave. No tongue can tell the awful fright and horror that prevailed among those dying victims in the mines of Avondale. A consultation then was held. They called for volunteers to go down in that dismal shaft and seek their comrades dear. Two Welshmen brave without dismay and courage without fail went down that shaft without delay to the mines of Avondale. But when the bottom they had reached and thought to make their way, one of them died from want of air, and the other without delay did give the sign to hoist him up, where he told the dreadful tale that all were lost forever in the mines of Avondale. The next two men that they sent down, they took of them good care, and every effort then was made to send down some good air as they traversed every chamber, and this time did not fail to find those miners' bodies in the mines of Avondale. 67 was the number that they at first had found. It seemed they were bewailing their fate beneath the ground. They found the father with his son wrapped in his arms so pale. It was a heart-rending scene in the mines of Avondale. Now to conclude and make an end, their number I'll pen down. 110 of brave strong men were smothered underground. They are in that grave till the last day, and their widows may well bewail and the orphan's cries still rend the skies all around our Avondale.